Hello friends and welcome back to Microbial Concepts. Today we are going to talk about the third step in central dogma, that is translation. We had completed replication and transcription. You can check the videos. I will mention the link in description box. So before starting to this topic, just let me remind you to subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon. Okay, and do share these videos with your friends. So about translation, so this is the step where mRNA is used to make or to synthesize proteins. Okay, so the genetic code that is present on mRNA that is translated into a protein using mRNA, tRNA, then amino acids and ribosomes. Okay, so the direction is 5 prime to 3 prime for mRNA is read, it is read to make N-terminal towards C-terminal proteins. Okay, so this is the direction of the process. So before starting to the actual process, just we should revise about messenger rRNA, ribosomal rRNA and transferrin rRNA. Okay, so let's start. So first, I am extremely sorry, it is not ATG, it is AUG, okay, it is not ATG, I am extremely sorry for this. So AUG is the start codon and then we have stop codons. Okay, so first is AUKR, that is UAA, then we have AMBER, that is UAG, and UGA is OPAL. Okay, so any of these three stop codons can terminate the process, and for initiation we need AUG. Okay, then there is another term which is known as cistron, the unit of rRNA that encodes one polypeptide chain is known as cistron. Okay, so the region of a gene that will code for a particular protein is known as cistron. So in case of prokaryotes, the mRNA is polycistronic, okay, while for eukaryotes the mRNA is monocistronic. Okay, that means for prokaryote a single mRNA, it will have genes which are overlapping on each other for various proteins. So using that gene we can, or the prokaryote can have many proteins synthesized. That is why it is known as polycistronic. And for eukaryotes, there is a single gene that will code for a protein. So there is no overlapping. There are separate genes for each of the protein. That's why a single mRNA gene that will code for a protein is known as monocistronic. Then next we have is ribosomal rRNA, also known as rRNA. Essential for protein synthesis, then ribosomes are approximately 60% of rRNA and 40% of protein by weight. Okay, so regarding rRNA or regarding these ribosomes, I had uploaded one more video separate. I will also mention the link in the description box. Okay, there are two parts, and I had covered bacterial ribosomes separately and eukaryotic separately. Okay, so in that this point is explained in detail. Okay, so you can check those videos. Next is ribosomes attach to mRNA and charge tRNA to make polypeptide chains. Okay, so this is the process that we are going to study further for the translation. The both prokaryote and eukaryote ribosomes are made up of large and small subunits. So this is the basic about ribosome, right? So there is a smaller subunit and a larger subunit. Okay, so this is the bacterial ribosome, which is made up of 70s, and this is the eukaryotic ribosome that is made up of 80s. Okay, so there is a large subunit, small subunit, same here, there is a large subunit, small subunit. Okay, so this is the basic for ribosomes. You should not mess up with this information. Okay, so you can check for more details on the separate video that I had uploaded. Let's go further. So next is tRNA, that is transfer RNA. Okay, so tRNA, it is known to carry amino acid to the ribosome to make a protein. Okay, so this is the structure of tRNA. Okay, so it is having three loops, and the fourth position is where at the 3' amino acid is attached. Okay, so you can see it is written amino acid accepting end. Then towards the second loop, towards the opposite of the amino acid, there is one more loop that is known as second loop or loop 2, where there is a anticodon present. Okay, why it is anticodon? Because it is complementary to the codon that is present on mRNA. Okay, so AUG is the start codon, right? We had seen previously, I had made a mistake there. ATG is wrong. I'm extremely sorry for that. AUG is the codon, start codon. Okay, so for that, the complementary codon is UAC. Okay, remember, for mRNA, there is no thymine, there is uracil. Okay, thymine is replaced by uracil. So A will bind to U, same way here, and C will bind to G, right? So that's why this codon, this triplet, is known as anticodon, right? And the one that is present on mRNA is known as codon. So there are specific tRNA for each codon and amino acid. So the tRNA, it is made up of 75 to 90 nucleotides in sequence, and the tRNA, it folds to form a specific shape called as clover leaf structure. Okay, this clover leaf structure, this tRNA, it resembles to that. Okay, so the clover leaf, it has actually three leaf. Okay, so these loops, if you see the original structure, it resembles to the clover leaf structure, right? Then there are two ends, 5' and 3' 5' and 3' towards the 3' end is where the amino acid is attached. Okay, then next is about tRNA charging or amino acylation. So what is this? What is charging of tRNA? Okay, so it is nothing but adding an amino acid to the tRNA is known as tRNA charging or amino acylation. An enzyme that adds the correct amino acid to corresponding tRNA is known as amino acyl tRNA synthetase. Okay, so this is the enzyme that adds the correct amino acid to the tRNA. The 3' nucleotide of tRNA is always CCA. Okay, so that is like this, CCA, and then towards this position, towards the adenine, next to the adenine is where the amino acid will bind. So how the amino acid binds to the second or third sugar of the adenine, that is A of the 3', right? So we had covered this point also about tRNA charging. Okay, so next is, in bacteria, transcription and translation can occur simultaneously. Okay, so ribosomes, they begin to translate the mRNA even before the RNA polymerase has finished the synthesizing it. Okay, so these both processes can go hand in hand. Okay, then in eukaryotes, the transcription, it takes place in nucleus, and translation, it takes place in cytoplasm. Okay, so this is the difference in bacterial transcription and translation and eukaryotic transcription and translation. Okay, next point is about Vogel hypothesis. So what is that? Actually, there are 61 different codons. Okay, so I am going to upload one more video regarding this genetic codons or genetic coding. Okay, so in that I will cover all this, but for now please remember that there are 61 different codons. Okay, so the triplet we had seen for anticodons, so they can form a combination of 61 different codons, but there are only 40 different tRNAs. Okay, how many? There are 40 different tRNAs. Why there should be 61, right? But no, there are only 40 and we have 61 codons. So how is that possible? So it is given by Francis Crick in 1966, that is known as the Wobble hypothesis. And what is that? The anticodon of certain tRNA can bind successfully to a codon whose third position requires non-standard base pairing. Okay, so this allows one tRNA to be able to base pair with more than one type of codon. Okay, so it is said that if you have one tRNA, it will not code for the single codon. It can code for more than one type of codon. That is why it is possible to have only 40 different tRNAs with 61 different codons. Okay, so this is Wobble hypothesis. Now let's start with the actual process of translation. So this is how we are going to study. There are three steps. First is initiation, then there is elongation, and third is termination. Okay, so first is the initiation. The ribosomal subunit and mRNA, they will assemble. The translation begins at the AUG codon. Why AUG codon? Because it is a start codon, right? So before starting that, there should be assembling of subunits of ribosome, that is 50S and 30S. Okay, so how that happens, that we will study first. There is IF, that means initiation factor. There are three initiation factors required with GTP, right? So first, initiation factor 2 with GTP will combine. To that complex will add FMET tRNA, that is the tRNA which is meant for AUG. Okay, so that will have a anticodon for AUG. Okay, so that will come and it will bind to have a complex of FMET, that is N-formyl methionine tRNA plus IF2 GTP. To this complex, now IF1, IF3 with mRNA and 30S will combine. Okay, so there is also requirement of Mg ions. It acts as cofactor. Okay, that will help in binding of 30S with 50S subunit. Okay, so now to this complex we are adding F1, that is initiation factor 1, initiation factor 3 with 30S. So 30S is already bound to mRNA. Okay, so now we will have a full complex of 30S, right? So that is going to carry FMET tRNA, IF1, IF2, GTP, IF3, mRNA, 30S, right? So this is the stable initiation complex that we are having. Now, this initiation complex, they will get released, okay? And the GTP will be get broken down. So now what we are having the stable assembly of our ribosome, that is 50S has attached, and that is when these initiation factors are released, they are removed. So we are having the FMET tRNA with mRNA and 30S and 50S attached to each other. So this is the point where the translation will start, or it will get initiated. So first is tRNA that binds is N-formyl methionine tRNA, as AUG codes for it. I had already mentioned that AUG is the start codon, and the first tRNA that will carry the amino acid is methionine. So that is why it is known as N-formyl methionine. It bounds to P site, then 50S ribosome gets attached to 30S ribosome to get converted into 70S. So this is what we had covered in the initiation complex. Okay, so now the initiation complex is complete and it is stable. Then the tRNA binds to the A site. Okay, so this is the initiation complex we had seen. So it actually the tRNA, it comes for binding to P site first. Okay, after the initiation complex is completed, then the tRNA, this tRNA will move to A site. okay, it will bind to A site along the process, and thus amino acid polymer is formed by translocation of tRNA from A site to P site to E site. And finally, tRNA exits from E site, it will get out, right. So this is the process where the ribosome, the 50s 38s unit with these EPA site, it will move further and the peptide formation will be in opposite direction, okay. Now next is elongation. So after binding of 30s and 50s, the methionine binds to leucine by peptide bond. The tRNA is released from P site, right, leaving methionine bound to the leucine. So now methionine will bind to leucine by peptide bond and move to P site, and glycine moves to A site. Again tRNA leaves the P site from the E site, leaving methionine, leucine and glycine bound to each other, okay. So let's see this in this diagram, okay. So this is the diagram for translation, you can draw this same in your exams. So this is the mRNA 30s 50s subunit already bound. So there is the first tRNA for the start codon, okay, that is coding for methionine, okay. So now it is going to leave by E site. Then the second tRNA that comes and that is having an anticodon for leucine, okay, the second codon, that is UUA, and the anticodon is AAU, right. So it is going to code for leucine, so that will come first to A site, it will bind to AUUA, right. Then after binding, it will form a bond with methionine and leucine, there will be a peptide bond formation at P site, okay, that is why the P site is known as peptidyl transfer, right. So here bond formation will take place, the tRNA is set free and now the tRNA will get exit from E site, right. A site is amino acid tRNA where the tRNA binds, it comes first, then the peptidyl transfer takes place at P site and then E is exit site for the tRNA, right. So this is how the tRNA comes for every codon, it will have amino acid bound towards its 3 prime end, the chain or the peptide formation will take place in this direction and the ribosome is moving towards this direction to translate the mRNA further, right. So this will keep on going until and unless the ribosome, it gets the stop codon, right, to terminate the process, right. So now methionine, leucine, it moves to the P site and glycine moves to the A site, okay. So the tRNA that is coding for the glycine, it comes towards the A site. Again tRNA leaves the P site from E site, leaving the methionine, leucine and glycine bound to each other. Thus tRNA comes to A site, then moves to P site, the peptide bond, that is amino acid, is linked and it leaves by E site, the chain of amino acid is formed. So this is about elongation, and then we are going towards the third step of translation, that is termination, okay. So stop codon in mRNA, it causes protein to release from ribosomes, okay. So there are three stop codons, OPL, AMBER and OCR, okay. UAA, it codes for OCR, then UAG for AMBER and UGA for OPL, okay. So these are the stop codons that will cause the termination of this translation process, and now the peptide is set free, all the assembly will now get separated, the ribosomal subunit separates from the mRNA and from one another, okay. So the protein is made by this process using the mRNA and ribosomes and tRNA, okay. So I hope this video is useful for you all. We had completed central dogma, okay, all the three steps I had explained, okay. So do share these videos with your friends and do subscribe my channel. Thanks a lot.